अग्निवीर योजना को लेकर के जनता ने रिजेंटमेंट दिखाया। हम चाहते हैं जो कॉन्ट्रोवर्सियल इश्यूज है उस पर बहस चलो।
जितने भी स्टेक होल्डर से चाहे मुख्यमंत्री हो या डिफरेंट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज हो या डिफरेंट सेक्ट्स हो, उनसे बातचीत करके इसका हल निकाला जाना चाहिए।
एक इस तरह की बात भी निकल कर आ रही है कि जेडीयू चाहता है कि अग्निवीर स्कीम की समीक्षा दोबारा से हो,
उसके बावजूद हम लोग अपने लक्ष्य से थोड़ा सा चूके हैं, तो इसका मतलब कहीं ना कहीं तो कमियां रही हैं।
आपको लगता है कि यूसीसी बाकी राज्यों में या पार्लियामेंट में शायद उस पर दोबारा सोचना पड़ेगा?
सरकार बनने के बाद संकल्प पत्र पर किस प्रकार से काम होना है, किस प्रकार से काम होगा, उन सब विषयों पर चूंकि चर्चा होने के बाद आगे बढ़ेगी चीजें।
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Indian politics doesn't have a single boring day. With the dust settling on the 2024 Lok Sabha elections, the wranglings over mantralayas and muddas have already kicked up a storm. Preparations are already underway for the Sunday swearing-in ceremony where Prime Minister Modi's government will be sworn in with backing of over 22 parties. 10 of them joining and taking the number right up to 303 will be sworn in at a historic third term for Prime Minister Modi. With hectic parleys and negotiations on more independence joining in, the arithmetic has improved for the NDA over the last 48 hours. Yet, even though they are 300 par, questions are now beginning to be raised by alliance partners. When it's a coalition, more is not necessarily merrier. Regional satraps like Chandrababu Naidu, Nitish Kumar, Chirag Paswan, Eknath Shinde have now become essential for the NDA's existence and survival in government. This immediately means that they will vie for their pound of flesh from one mantralaya for four members of parliament as the formula from UCC being put on the back burner, Agnipath scheme needing to be looked at. Every mudda now has become a bargaining chip. The more portfolios that the BJP concedes, the lesser will be the scope for hard policy decisions, and the BJP knows that. So it sent out a message to its own partners that the Cabinet Committee on Security Portfolios will not be shared, which is defense, home, finance and foreign affairs will continue to remain with the BJP. But what's really put the BJP in such a tight spot with little elbow room? Those questions are really being looked at within the BJP as well as the supporters of the BJP who are looking at this not so comfortable position for the BJP. The Congress with their 99 seats are today mocking Prime Minister Modi, saying 58% Bhartiyon ne Modi ke khilaf vote diya hai. Tonight, we will do a deep dive into the hits and misses by the BJP and the reasons why their own bastions were breached. Look at the group of 20 ministers who lost their own seats, some of them by margins over 1 lakh votes, while others with very, very narrow margins. And those names on your screen tell you just how much may have gone wrong with the BJP if 20 ministers have lost their seats in these elections. While the BJP performed well in states like Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Delhi and Gujarat, why was its performance lackluster elsewhere? Let's tell you about the big three losses for the BJP. The focus is on three large states of Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra and Rajasthan. In UP, BJP went from 71 seats in 2014 to 62 seats in 2019 and now down to only 33 seats. In Maharashtra, where BJP used to have 23 seats in 2014 and 2019, it slipped to just 9 seats in 2024. In Rajasthan, the BJP has slipped from 25 in 2014, 24 in 2019 to now 14 seats in 2024. In the case of Uttar Pradesh, 7 union ministers have lost their seats in just this one state. The victory margin of Prime Minister also going down, clearly showing signs of trouble at the ground level. The BJP won only 8 out of the 17 SC reserved seats, losing 8 seats from 2019. Out of these 8, 5 of them went to the Samajwadi Party. And this has led to some BJP leaders to question a possible sabotage that has been stated in UP. Listen in to BJP's Member of Parliament in the Rajya Sabha.
एक तरीके से पार्टी के साथ विश्वासघात किया ऐसे लोगों ने, और इसकी जांच जो है गहराई से होनी चाहिए, प्रत्येक जिले अनुसार होनी चाहिए कि कौन कौन ऐसे लोग हैं जिन्होंने पार्टी के नेतृत्व के खिलाफ, हमारे पार्टी के कैंडिडेट के खिलाफ अपनी भूमिका निभाई है।
मैंने, मेरे इन हाथों ने अयोध्या की धरती को राम भक्तों के लहू से लाल लाल होते देखा है। राम भक्तों को मैंने उठाया है, लेकिन क्या दुर्भाग्य है, उसी अयोध्या ने आज समाजवादी पार्टी का सांसद बना दिया। तो ये कुल मिलाकर के जो कुछ उत्तर प्रदेश में घटना घटित हुई है चुनाव को लेकर, ये चिंता का विषय भी है।
विपक्षियों ने जो अपने हिसाब से मुद्दे बनाए थे उसको उन लोगों ने कैश कराया, हमको लगता है उस पर बैठ के विचार होगा, देखा जाएगा।
Now let's look at the other big state, Maharashtra, which has 48 seats. Here, BJP has registered its biggest loss since 1998. When it comes to the swing, in fact, you can see how the BJP over the decades has consolidated its seats to 23 in 2019. But this time, it dropped to only 9 seats, a swing of minus 40. The biggest losses for the BJP in Maharashtra have been the SC-ST belt. In the SC reserved seats, Congress won 4 seats and Uddhav Sena won 1. BJP won none. Out of the 4 scheduled tribe seats, Congress and allies won 3 and BJP won only 1. Across in Rajasthan too, Congress secured big gains with 4 seats in the Jat belt. Congress also bagged 4 seats in the eastern Rajasthan belt, which has the big Gujjar Meena presence. Even Congress's allies managed to win in the Gujjar Meena belt. All of this was at the cost of the BJP. Now, it is some of these numbers, some of these messages that are actually worrying the BJP, even when the BJP could hold on to its turf in Chhattisgarh, in Madhya Pradesh, Bihar. Why couldn't it do so in Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh is the question on everybody's mind. So, ladies and gentlemen, the legitimate question that we're asking on the News Hour tonight: how were the BJP bastions breached? Is there a story there? Is there merit in the questions that are being raised within the party? That's the question and that's the debate coming up on the other side.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Joining the debate tonight, Gaurav Bhatia, National Spokesperson of the BJP, Harshvardhan Tripathi, Senior Journalist, Sabha Naqvi, Senior Journalist, Tehseen Poonawala, Political Analyst, supports the Congress Party, Rajkumar Bhati, National Spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. My first question to you, Gaurav Bhatia. Gaurav Bhatia, Member of Parliament in the Rajya Sabha from your own party, raising questions of why and what went wrong in Uttar Pradesh, even questioning whether antarghat tha koi, which means internal sabotage. Also, the fact that Devendra Fadnavis has offered to quit and step down. What's going on in the BJP? And is there a possibility of an internal sabotage in some of the big states where the BJP has had a poor showing, which has led to its defensive position today? In formation of government at the center.
Navika, first of all, there is no defensive position in the BJP or the NDA. We are playing on the front foot, and I'll tell you the reasons why. There has been a historic mandate for the Bharatiya Janata Party And we all know that after the 1962 elections, there has never been a leader who has been consecutively elected by the people thrice, and that too with the same vote percentage. Even Jawaharlal Nehru in 1962 had a diminished vote bank by 3%. Second, who has the maximum number of MPs? The Bharatiya Janata Party. The second largest party is the Congress, which is around 35% of the Bharatiya Janata Party with 240 MPs. Who has the highest number of scheduled caste MPs? It is the Bharatiya Janata Party. The highest number of women MPs? It is the Bharatiya Janata Party. Members of the ST community, the maximum MPs come from the Bharatiya Janata Party. Therefore, I would say it is the Bharatiya Janata Party which has shown that through hard work, there is pro-incumbency and there is no such thing as anti-incumbency. The next more important point is that we must understand that the Congress party, which is saying that this is their moral victory, have been, you know, hit wicket at 99, nervous 90. And let me remind them of two numbers which are very crucial. That since 1991, they have never even touched the 240 mark. So it's been 33 years they've been losing badly, wounded badly. They've lost the confidence of the people. Second, in 2004, what was the number of seats they had? They had 145 seats. And still, they formed an alliance which was not a pre-poll alliance. In 2009, they had 206 seats. So Bharatiya Janata Party's worst performance in the last 10 years is better than the best performance of the Congress party in the last 33 years. Third, I think on Sunday, we will see Shri Narendra Modi ji again being sworn in as the Prime Minister. It would be a Barnaul moment for the opposition. Why don't you just bother about your own alliance? Begani Shadi mein Abdullah Diwana, aapko kya farak padta hai bhai? We have our alliance partner. It's a pre-poll alliance. It's a very stable one.
Gaurav Bhatia, and they all are Gaurav Bhatia, whether it affects them or not, it's not about the opposition. It's about your own MPs who are now raising this question, as Harnath Singh ji raised. You haven't answered the question of why Devendra Fadnavis offered to quit. Why?
Yes, I will answer that.
Yes.
I will answer that.
Please answer the UP, the Rajasthan and the Maharashtra question.
I will. Navika, the beauty of the Bharatiya Janata Party is not one leader came out to say that the EVMs have been hacked, the Election Commission of India has not done its job. They have been charging us that there is no internal democracy. If I think Harnath Singh Yadav and others have spoken, though that is not the party viewpoint, but I would still say that shows there is internal democracy. Third, either the Bharatiya Janata Party wins or we learn. And I am telling you that there would be a very deep introspection why we have lost. But in Uttar Pradesh, I can tell you that we have got 71 seats in the past, then 64 seats. Seats have come down, maybe because there are certain things that need to be changed. But at this juncture, without analyzing, without having, you know, a deep analysis, how can I make a comment? I think we should wait for the time to come when we will analyze the loss that we've suffered in terms of the seats that we have, and we'll come up with the numbers. In Rajasthan, Navika, just a few months back, we formed the state government there, and people are with us in Rajasthan. We all know that if certain number of seats have come down, it is only because we had outperformed every person and party, and therefore, you know, there was a downside to it. We have come down. That doesn't mean it's the end of the world. We need to introspect and get better.
Well, Tehsin Poonawala, they seem to be a machinery which will do the introspection because, well, everybody's noticed that the BJP over the last 10 years has been a party with a machinery that plays to win. Even this time around, yes, their numbers have come down, but they've still won. They are the largest party. The summation of all the India bloc alliances have not been able to stop them in their tracks. They are 240. all of the India Alliance partners are at 234. Now they've added to their kitty more alliance partners. 292 was the pre-poll NDA. Now it's at 303. The question here is, why is the opposition celebrating so much the problems within the BJP when they're still going ahead and forming the government?
So, Navika, thank you so much for having me on the show. Good evening to you, to all my fellow panelists, and to all your viewers. Why is the opposition celebrating? At the onset, congratulations to the Prime Minister, the BJP and its allies. They should be celebrating. They're forming the government. Of course, the opposition will be happy. Why should they not be happy? Every single exit poll funded, and I'm seeing this with a lot of responsibility, I hope I'm not stopped, by fund managers and fund houses, who, in my opinion, I take responsibility for this, showed the BJP getting 400 plus seats and asked people to invest money, thereby leading to several losses of common citizens. I hope the SEBI investigates it. Should be investigated. Who was doing what? The opposition was written off. The opposition spoke about 295 seats. They ended at 232. This is the India Alliance. The Honorable Prime Minister and Parliament thundered, "Main akela sabpe bhari, abki baar 400 paar, Modi ki guarantee." That's been rejected. Yes, the opposition is a few seats short, but the BJP and the alliance is many seats short. So there's celebration as who's been rejected. Navika, the first three words of our constitution are "We the people." The people of India are celebrating because for once they have a government which in the last 10 years could subjugate people. It could come at 8 p.m. on Times Now and say, in the next 4 hours, your money is not legal. It is not legal tender. That won't happen now. So there's a sigh of relief. There's a sigh that you can breathe easily. But one last point. There has been sabotage not just in UP. There's been severe disappointment with the BJP in Maharashtra. And I've shared this off record with you, and allow me to put this. In Maharashtra, the voters of the BJP were disappointed, particularly with one man in the alliance, Ajit Pawar. Ajit Pawar, the whole reason a lot of Congress voters shifted en masse to BJP was Ajit Pawar and his politics. The same Ajit Pawar, who none other than the Prime Minister and Devendra Fadnavis criticizes today, a proud member of the BJP and stuttering with the BJP. Devendra Fadnavis is a good chief minister. Today is half a deputy chief minister. That has hurt the core BJP voters. BJP is losing Maharashtra and Haryana. Take it in writing from me. In these two assembly elections, BJP is going to be wiped out in these
Well, I won't remind you. Correct. I won't remind you, you said to take it in writing from you that the please Congress party would get 190 seats.
That was ETG polls. Were ETG polls.
No. You said 190 seats for the Congress.
No, I told you 190, 290 for the Alliance.
No, you said 190 for the Congress. I'll bring out that clip. I'll bring out that clip because I have the record right here. But Gaurav Bhatia wants to respond to you.
Okay.
You know, a Tehsin has turned out to be a sophologist who's always wrong. Because, Navika, you just mentioned, he was there in the debate with me also. And he said that the Ghamandia group would be the largest group. And it didn't happen. Madhya Pradesh, he said, Kamal Nath will become the chief minister. It did not happen. And Tehsin has one quality. He accepts defeat with humility. But the people of the country are still waiting that Congress party Rahul Gandhi and Kharge ji should come out and at least concede defeat. They should congratulate the Prime Minister. We can expect that from them or not. Tehsin, my friend, you said, ek akela sab par bhari. Main uska bhi uttar de deta hoon. You tell me who won the election. BJP on its own got 240 seats versus Congress, Samajwadi Party, RJD, AAP, TMC, DMK, Shiv Sena, Uddhav, NCP, Sharad Pawar, JMM, CPI, CPIM, IUML and National Conference. Total 230 seats. Now you tell me, who won? We have on our own 240 seats and all these parties combined together are at 230-232. I think Bharatiya Janata Party alone, ek akela sab par bhari, has been proven right. Don't you think I'm giving you the facts to substantiate that Narendra Modi ji's persona, his stature cannot be matched by these allies?
Well, Tehsin, respond to Gaurav, but before that, also respond to the voters who've queued up outside the Congress office in Lucknow, asking for the khatakhat. They have the form and they've been asked to come to the Congress office. Wo bhi dilwa do zara paise.
वो भी राहुल गांधी ने कहा था नाविका जी, राहुल गांधी की गारंटी है ही नहीं।
Just two things, Navika. The Honorable Home Minister of India in his interview to you gave a certain figure. The Honorable Prime Minister gave a certain figure. Look, in politics, you're not going to put your troops down. After the first phase, the BJP knew they were in trouble in Tamil Nadu, Rajasthan. You and I have spoken about this off the record. But you don't put your troops down. Of course, the number you give on camera and you give off camera are different. Why didn't you ask this question to the Prime Minister? Why has his numbers not come to Honorable Home Minister, who's called Chanakya? Look at what actually is happening. We should see it in that perspective. And in that perspective, in Varanasi, on that boat, I told you, Navika ji, that the Prime Minister is struggling in Varanasi. I said this to you off record and on record. And the Prime Minister did struggle in Varanasi. I think the BJP should reflect upon it.
Well, 1.5 lakh votes margin, one if you still call that a struggle, then it's all right. But let me get in Rajkumar Bhati ji. Rajkumar Bhati ji, chunav mein aap jeete ya BJP hari? सवाल आज ये उठ रहा है और ये बीजेपी के अंदर से भी उठ रहा है, पब्लिक भी पूछ रही है, ये बीजेपी की गलतियां थी जिससे आप जीत गए या फिर कुछ ऐसा जादू चला खटाखट का और पीडीए का? क्योंकि ये जादू अगर उत्तर प्रदेश में चला तो बिहार में नहीं चल पाया, अगर इतना अच्छा फॉर्मूला था तो बिहार में भी चलना चाहिए था, मध्य प्रदेश में भी चलना चाहिए था, छत्तीसगढ़ में भी चलना चाहिए था, वहां तो नहीं चला, तो कारण क्या है?
नाविका जी, कारण दोनों ही हैं, जैसा कि आपने कहा। एक तो हमारे नेता, ये मेरी आवाज लौट के मुझे वापस आ रही है, कृपया इसे ठीक करा दें। एक तो हमारे नेता की मेहनत, हमारे नेता की प्रतिबद्धता अपने मुद्दों के प्रति, अपने घोषणा पत्र के प्रति, जनता की जो जेन्युइन समस्याएं हैं उनको उठाना, हवाबाजी की बातें, इधर उधर की बातें न करना, जाति धर्म के मुद्दों में न उलझना और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के जाल में न फंसना, अपने एजेंडे पे, अपने मुद्दे पे चुनाव को लेकर आना, ये भी उसके लिए जिम्मेदार है। दूसरे, भारतीय जनता पार्टी की एरोगेंस, वो खास तौर से उत्तर प्रदेश के मुख्यमंत्री का बड़बोलापन और धमकी की भाषा बोलना और परफॉर्मेंस के नाम पे जीरो, भाषणबाजी के नाम पे हीरो, ये जो भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने, और भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने लगातार बड़े लोगों को फायदा पहुंचाने के लिए, गरीब लोगों का दमन करने के लिए, चाहे वो वाराणसी हो चाहे अयोध्या हो, दोनों जगह की रिपोर्ट आपके सामने होंगी। अब रिपोर्ट इसके बाद भी आ रही है। अभी गौरव भाटिया जो इतिहास गिनवा रहे थे कांग्रेस की, कब कितनी सीटें आई, कैसे कैसे सरकार बनी, हम तो हमेशा कहते रहे हैं कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी वर्तमान समस्याओं से मुंह छिपाती है, उनसे नजरें चुराती है और इतिहास में रहना चाहती है, इतिहास में जीना चाहती है। एक बात उन्होंने कहा कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी कभी ईवीएम को या चुनाव आयोग को दोष नहीं देती, हम हार भी स्वीकार करते हैं, लेकिन अगर आप सोशल मीडिया खंगालें, एक अयोध्या की सीट हारने पे भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लोगों की भाषा कितनी अभद्र हो गई है, सोशल मीडिया पे कितनी गाली गलौज कर रहे हैं, अयोध्या के लोगों को गाली दे रहे हैं, हिंदुओं को गाली दे रहे हैं, ये हिंदू गुलामी के ही लायक हैं, हिंदू इसी लायक हैं, हिंदुओं का कभी कुछ नहीं हो सकता, अपने गिरेबान में नहीं झांकेंगे कि आपने अयोध्या में कई हजार लोगों को उजाड़ दिया, कई हजार दुकानें तोड़ दी, मकान तोड़ दिए और उनको 1-1 लाख रुपया पकड़ा के जबरन डंडे के बल पे पुलिस से डंडा चलवा के भगा दिया। गुजरात के लोग आके अयोध्या में, वाराणसी में बिजनेस कर रहे हैं और जो वहां का लोकल आदमी है भूखा मरने की स्थिति में पहुंच गया है। और जिस तरह से उत्तर प्रदेश में ओबीसी के अधिकारों का दमन हुआ, टीचर भर्ती में हाईकोर्ट का आदेश है कि 8,000
खत्म हो गए
लोगों की भर्ती और की जा, लेकिन 6,800 की, 6,800
चुनाव खत्म हो गए भाटी जी, चुनाव खत्म हो गए हैं, आप 37 सीट जीत चुके हैं, फिर भी कैंपेन मोड में क्यों चले?
पूछा, मैं तो कारण गिनवा रहा हूँ। आपने कारण पूछे नाविका जी, मैं कारण गिनवा रहा हूँ। किसानों को गाड़ियों से कुचला गया और फिर उनको एक टिकट दिए गए, उसे भी सबक सिखा दिया यूपी के किसानों ने,
सैनी
को भी हरा दिया,
बैड टिकट सिलेक्शन, बैड कैंडिडेट सिलेक्शन। गौरव भाटिया,
देखिए, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मुझे भाटी जी को बधाई देनी है, उनका प्रदर्शन वाकई बेहतर हुआ और इसमें कोई संकोच नहीं होना चाहिए कहने में, क्योंकि जब तक स्वीकारेंगे नहीं तो हम बेहतर कैसे होंगे। लेकिन मैं एक बात जरूर कहूंगा और मर्यादा में रहते हुए कहूंगा, योगी आदित्यनाथ जी को जीरो बता रहे हैं। एक बात मत भूलिएगा, 2017 में जीरो समाजवादी पार्टी को बना दिया था, 2022 में जीरो समाजवादी पार्टी को बना दिया था।
मैंने जीरो नहीं कहा,
ये भी मत भूलिएगा। जीरो नहीं कहा, आपने बात करी। अच्छा शांत, आपने हीरो और जीरो बोला था, हीरो और जीरो।
भाषा घमंड भरी होती है।
मैंने सम्मान दिया, आप भी सम्मान दीजिए। आपकी आपकी कोई
नहीं बोला था, गलत कोट कर रहे
हैं। करता हूं, पहली बात इन्होंने एक कही भाषा की। अच्छा ठीक है, भाषा की इन्होंने बात करी। इनका मीडिया सेल का इंचार्ज किसी महिला को कहता है कि पिचकारी चला दूंगा और अखिलेश यादव डिफेंड करने जाते हैं उसे, तो कम से कम भाषा की बात मत करिए। दूसरा, आपने कहा हम धर्म की बात नहीं कर रहे थे चुनाव में, ये राम मंदिर का नक्शा खराब है, ये तो रामगोपाल यादव ने कहा था। और वोट जिहाद के,
लेकिन फिर भी जीत गए
आपकी नेत्री,
फिर भी फैजाबाद जीत गए।
वो ठीक है, अभी अभी बात जीत हार की नहीं हो रही है, अभी बात हो रही है धर्म का दुरुपयोग कौन कर रहा था, वोट जिहाद की बात कौन कर रहा था। और जो भी जनता ने जनादेश दिया है वो सर आंखों पर है नाविका जी। कभी ऐसा नहीं होगा कि भाजपा का प्रवक्ता आके ये कहे कि ईवीएम गड़बड़ा गई थी या राक्षस है जनता, जैसा सुरजेवाला ने कहा था इनके घटक दल के साथी।
वेल लेट मी गेट इन सबा नकवी एंड हर्षवर्धन त्रिपाठी, द टू सीनियर जर्नलिस्ट, एंड यू नो लेट मी अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम देम। Sabha Naqvi, what do you think? Let's get straight to the point. Let's cut out the chase and let's get straight to the point. What were the reasons? If the BJP can do well in Chhattisgarh, if the BJP can do well in Madhya Pradesh, if they can do well in Gujarat, if they can do well in Himachal, Uttarakhand, if they can actually better their performance down south, what is it that went wrong in these three states, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra and Rajasthan?
So Navika, Maharashtra was always, the writing was on the wall. The BJP people felt the BJP...
The washing machine argument.
They betrayed the mandate. The BJP broke people and it was against the nature of the BJP. The BJP, you tell, why should a party and a karyakarta who is campaigning against Ashok Chauhan and Ajit Pawar one day suddenly be told to support them? This is what was happening in Maharashtra. It was pretty ruthless. It was a smash and grab. That is what it was. The writing was on the wall. One didn't expect it, that it would be so bad for the BJP. Honestly, I was talking to people from there all the time. People still thought BJP will do better. It was on the wall for months. I can talk the maximum about Uttar Pradesh, where do you remember that on the boat? On the board that day, I said that in the three, but I'm talking now about two, in Kashi and in Ayodhya, you're going to see the margins come down. I never thought BJP would lose Ayodhya. And in Kashi, the PM's margins have come down, Navika. And you know that in Varanasi South, which is where the corridor and all has been built, it's very narrow. So just breaking down the assembly segments that go into a Lok Sabha seat. The worst segment is Varanasi South. So these are important indications. One of them is...
Wouldn't that be expected if parties come together and their votes combine? It would be expected that last time Samajwadi Party and Congress fought separately.
Navika, we must remember that in Ayodhya, it is a Dalit candidate in a general seat. He has defeated the BJP candidate in a general seat. The reasons are very simple from the journalists there. They were just smashing our city down. They were treating it like a VIP person. They were bullying us. We were scared. We kept quiet and then we voted against them. That's what's happened there. I'm not even saying that I predicted Ayodhya. But I knew that the margin is coming down, and now that it's happened, it's a very significant, a Dalit candidate in a general category seat has won that for you. So that's one thing. Of course, we will all say that the Dalit vote, they wanted to vote against the BJP. And Mayawati was not really contesting against anyone because she was not part of it. So a lot of them shifted. Again, very, very hard for, unless you live there, to be sure that this is happening. Because people are cautious. The poorer you are, the more cautious you are. They have, I'll tell you one thing, Navika, which somebody said to me, हम राशन से बॉन्डेड लेबर नहीं बनने वाले हैं, बंधवा मजदूर जो शब्द था हिंदी का, तो ये बहुत, एक तो बीजेपी को इसको टैकल करना पड़ेगा क्योंकि अल्टीमेटली एंड अल्टीमेटली इट इज अ कंट्री ऑफ द पुअर. ये परसेप्शन कि ये अमीरों की पार्टी है पीएम मोदी के लिए और कि अब गरीबों का कोलिशन बना है, ये पार्टी के लिए रियलिटी होगी.
हर्षवर्धन त्रिपाठी, हर्षवर्धन त्रिपाठी इज डिसएग्री विद.
हिंदू मुस्लिम पे नहीं हुआ ये चुनाव, आप हिंदू मुस्लिम पे मत जाइए. ये हुआ है अमीर गरीब दलित दलित
पर. उत्तर प्रदेश में अमीर गरीब दलित और मध्य प्रदेश में नहीं, बिहार में नहीं. हर्षवर्धन त्रिपाठी जी,
नविका जी, अगर अमीर गरीब पे हुआ तो ब्रजभूषण का बेटा करण भूषण कैसे जीत गया, इस सवाल का जवाब आना चाहिए. मैं जानता हूँ कि जब 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 बात होती है तो कई बार हम जर्नलिस्ट अपने मन में जो रहता है उसको किसी भी एक नतीजे के साथ इस्टेब्लिश करने की कोशिश करते हैं. उत्तर प्रदेश में जो हुआ, सबसे पहले तो एक निश्चित तौर पर अखिलेश यादव ने बेटर कॉस्ट कास्ट कॉम्बिनेशन दिया. उन्होंने कोशिश की, जिसकी आलोचना हो रही थी वो सब उस वक्त लोगों को समझ में नहीं आया, लेकिन बहुत मजे से उन्होंने जो पासी समाज के लोगों को, कुर्मी समाज के लोगों को, मौर्य समाज के लोगों को, और कुर्मी स्ट्रेटेजिक वोटिंग पिछले दो चुनाव से कर रहा है. अनुप्रिया के पार्टी के होने के बावजूद, पार्टी से साथ होने के बावजूद अनुप्रिया अपनी दूसरी सीट हार गई, यानी मिर्जापुर वो जहां से लड़ती थी जीती, रॉबर्ट्सगंज हार गई. विधानसभा के चुनाव में केशव प्रसाद मौर्य को सिराथू में अनुप्रिया की बहन पल्लवी पटेल हरा देती है. यानी कुर्मी कोई भारतीय जनता पार्टी और अपना दल के साथ वोट नहीं कर रहा था, स्ट्रेटेजिक वोटिंग कर रहा था. बीजेपी ने जो अमित शाह ने जो कास्ट कॉम्बो बनाया था, 14-19 में चला, 17-22 में चला, लेकिन 19 में अलार्मिंग हो गया था, 22 में उसके खतरे दिखने लगे थे. और कमाल की बात यह है कि योगी आदित्यनाथ राजपूत नेता के तौर पर भी सबसे ज्यादा राजपूत, जिसको हम कहते हैं ना नाराजगी दिखना, धनंजय सिंह, रघुराज प्रताप सिंह. और कमाल की बात यह कि अभय सिंह को आप लेकर आए गोसाईगंज से, राकेश प्रताप सिंह को लेकर आए गौरीगंज से, वो भी नहीं काम किया. जो सबसे बड़ी मुश्किल है, अगर हर दूसरे दिन खबर आएगी कि अमित शाह और योगी आदित्यनाथ में तो कुछ चल रहा है. कमाल की बात यह है कि नरेंद्र मोदी योगी आदित्यनाथ के लिए कहते हैं यूपी प्लस योगी उपयोगी, और रोज खबर आएगी कि अमित शाह ये नहीं करने दे रहे हैं, योगी आदित्यनाथ ये कर दे रहे हैं. और मैं यहां एक बात बता दूं, ये विशुद्ध व्हाट्सएप यूनिवर्सिटी का है कि कोई योगी आदित्यनाथ ने 30-35 नामों की लिस्ट भेजी थी, कोई ऐसी लिस्ट नहीं भेजी थी. एक तो भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने कैंडिडेट बदले नहीं, जहां बदले वर्स्ट कैंडिडेट सिलेक्शन किया. नीरज शेखर को बलिया से टिकट क्यों दिया, साकेत मिश्रा को श्रावस्ती से टिकट क्यों दिया, और नीरज त्रिपाठी को इलाहाबाद से टिकट क्यों दिया, ये कुछ मैं बता रहा हूं. संगम लाल गुप्ता के खिलाफ साफ साफ नाराजगी थी, विनोद सोनकर के खिलाफ साफ साफ नाराजगी थी. एक तरह से कहें जो ये पूर्वांचल का पूरा इलाका है, यहां प्रत्याशियों को जनता बता रही थी भैया इनको हम वोट नहीं देंगे, मोदी के हम साथ खड़े. और दूसरा, राजस्थान का पूरा कैसे चुनाव पलटा, सिर्फ दो सीट से, चुरू में राहुल कसवा और बाड़मेर जैसलमेर में रविंद्र सिंह भाटी. इसके अलावा कोई और ऐसी नाराजगी नहीं थी, लेकिन उसको भी जो भाजपा के नेता है वो मैनेज नहीं कर पाए, इसको स्वीकार कीजिए. इसके अलावा नविका जी, हिंदुत्व चला, मोदी ब्रांड इंटैक्ट है, भारतीय जनता पार्टी की डेवलपमेंट पॉलिटिक्स इंटैक्ट है, अमीर गरीब का चुनाव है तो ओडिशा गरीब राज्यों में है, चुन लिया भारतीय जनता पार्टी को क्योंकि गरीब सब भारतीय जनता पार्टी के साथ. मंडला की सीट जिसमें कहा जा रहा था कि फग्गन सिंह कुलस्ते हार जाएंगे, आदिवासियों ने जम के वोट किया, मंडला धार भी जीत गए और 29 की 29 सीटें मध्य प्रदेश में लेकर आ गए. तो मुझे लगता है यूपी एक्सेप्शन है, राजस्थान में भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लोग देख रहे थे उसको नहीं कर पाए. हाँ, महाराष्ट्र में मानूंगा जो आपने कहा, ये वॉशिंग मशीन नहीं चलेगा भैया. आप किसी को लेके आओगे, आप कल तक उसको गाली दोगे और कहोगे हमारे साथ आ जाओ, तो ये चलेगा नहीं, कितना भी आप उसको डिफेंड करते रहे.
सभा नकवी,
मैं बस यही कहूंगी कि ये इन्होंने कहा कि जो मन में है वो कह दिया. देखिए, बहुत बड़ी हार हुई है यूपी में, और आप यूपी का उड़ीसा से, डोंट कंपेयर यूपी विद उड़ीसा, राइट. उड़ीसा बीजेपी इज अ न्यू एंट्री, फिनोमिनल, बीजेपी इज वेरी गुड एट न्यू ग्राउंड. यूपी वॉज ऑल्सो न्यू ग्राउंड इन 2014 व्हेन नरेंद्र मोदी केम, द बीजेपी 171 सीट्स फ्रॉम देयर. उसके बाद सो नाउ, बट आई ऑन वन ऑफ योर शोज आई ऑल्सो सेड यूपी इज नॉट गुजरात, एंड इवन इन गुजरात देर हैज बीन लॉसेज, देर हैज बीन अ अमेजिंग सीट, अमेजिंग लॉस विद एट द हैंड्स ऑफ एन अमेजिंग वुमन हु क्राउड फंडेड हर रिसोर्सेज, who crowdfunded to stand for the campaign in Banaskantha. So we have to appreciate the small, there has been an amazing, the best result, strike rate of the opposition in Bihar has come from Male, which has no money, which collects 20-20 rupees.
There is no such thing like Amir and Gareeb.
Allow me to finish, I may not interrupt you. अलाउ मी टू फिनिश. यू हैव प्रदीप जी, आपकी अपनी राय होती है, मुझे तो क्लियर ट्रेंड दिख रहा है और प्रधानमंत्री देखेंगे. उन्होंने, मुझे याद है एक बार जब सूट बूट की बात चली थी, लैंड एक्विजिशन बिल, उसके बाद उन्होंने प्रो पुअर इमेज अक्वायर की. इस बार गलत बीजेपी का ये पुअर रिच परसेप्शन गया है कि मोदी जी अब अमीरों के नेता बन गए हैं. क्यों
गौरव भाटिया इज कंटेस्टिंग यू? गौरव भाटिया इज कंटेस्टिंग यू. हर्षवर्धन त्रिपाठी इज कंटेस्टिंग यू. क्विक 30 seconds टू यू हर्षवर्धन जी.
आर्ग्यू नहीं कर रही, मैं इंटेलेक्चुअल इनपुट दे रही हूँ. आई एम नॉट आर्ग्यूइंग, आई एम गिविंग माय
जनरल. एवरीबॉडी हैज अ काउंटर टू द पॉइंट दैट यू मेड एंड दैट्स व्हाट अ डिबेट इज ऑल अबाउट.
देखिए सभा जी जो और बातें कर रही है वो बिल्कुल दुरुस्त है, लेकिन अमीर गरीब वाला मसला जिस देश में 4 करोड़ लोगों को एक सरकार घर देती हो वो गरीब नहीं सुनेगा. जिस देश में 8 करोड़ लोगों को रसोई गैस देती है वो गरीब नहीं सुनेगा. और मैं फिर से कह रहा हूं, ये अमीर गरीब का चुनाव तो कतई नहीं था. हाँ ये जरूर है, भारतीय जनता पार्टी शायद उसकी मशीनरी वो भांपने में कामयाब नहीं हो सकी कि संविधान आरक्षण खत्म हो रहा है उसको किस तरह से दिमाग में बिठा दिया गया है. बहुजन समाज पार्टी को बीजेपी की बी टीम कह दिया गया और उसमें बीजेपी बीएसपी के जब कैंडिडेट चेंज होने लगे तो उत्तर प्रदेश में उनको लगा कि भाई ये हो सकता. और सबसे बड़ी बात, बीजेपी को ये ध्यान रखना होगा उसकी जो संघ की मशीनरी है, उसका जो अपना कार्यकर्ता है, उसका जो ओरिजिनल वर्कर है, वो अगर अपमानित महसूस करेगा तो उसको मुश्किल होगी. वो नीचे तक परिवारों में जाकर बात नहीं स्थापित करना.
होलसेल यू नो एंट्रीज, एमिनेंट पर्सनैलिटी is joining the BJP from other parties, was that the undoing also of the BJP's decision making and alienating the cadres? Gaurav Bhatia,
see, as I said that I would not make a premature comment. I think there would be a very deep analysis, everything would be considered. And Bharatiya Janata Party, as I earlier also said, is a party that learns from its mistakes. I'll give you an example. The election in 2017, Gujarat election, I remember Sabha Naqvi ji, when Congress started leading, she stood up. Even in your studio, I was sitting next to her. She started clapping. The Bharatiya Janata Party has lost. We got 99 seats. 99. It was premature clapping by Sabha Naqvi, who says that she is a political analyst. But later, when we reanalyzed the results, next election, Navika, we created history. Yes. Maximum number of seats in Gujarat, 160 approximately. 64. So I would say that introspection is due and it will be done. Second, if you call yourself a journalist, Sabhaji, it is important that you place the correct facts. You said Bharatiya Janata Party in Maharashtra betrayed the mandate. Do you remember the assembly election? There was a pre-poll alliance with the combined Shiv Sena Uddhav Thackeray. We got a clear mandate. Uddhav Thackeray took a U-turn. He joined the Ghamandiya or the Mahavikas.
That's Agari. Fine. That's so fine. But after that, the shenanigans of the BJP and I agree with Sabha on that. At least on Maharashtra, I agree that Ajit Pawar and breaking of the Shiv Sena. I'm running out of time, Gaurav Bhatia, but I'm just saying that Ajit Pawar is a question that we've asked the Prime Minister, we asked the Home Minister, and it was a sore thumb that was standing out in a party that was fighting against corruption. Those issues clearly have been picked up by the voters. Clearly, I have no doubt, and I disagree with Sabha when she says BJP is only good on new ground. No, because BJP is won in Uttar Pradesh twice. It's won in Madhya Pradesh countless number of
Rajasthan
times. Maybe not just Gujarat, but there are Chhattisgarh states that BJP has won again and again and again. So there is no one size fits all explanation that can be put to every single bad performance, but clearly BJP is a machinery that will have to learn from their mistakes because the writing is on the wall. But meanwhile, government formation at high speed, there is a baithak that is going on, four very senior people You can guess who they are sitting together in a huddle, all the final touches being given before the talks with the alliance partners tomorrow, when Chandrababu Naidu, Nitish Kumar and other alliance partners will land in Delhi with all their members of parliament. But preparations for hosting 7,000 to 8,000 people at the forecourt of Rashtrapati Bhavan on Sunday evening post 6:30 p.m. preparations already on. So we'll leave it at that and we'll keep you posted on all the developments. But as I thank all my panelists on debate number one,